Now it's easier than ever to get a high-quality podcast recording remotely. In this video, I'm going to take you through how you can record remotely with video so that you can have more guests on your show and make the production process much more simple. All right, let's get right into it. If you're looking to record a podcast remotely, the first thing you're gonna need to do is set up your studio. So let's talk about microphones, because good audio quality can make or break a good podcast episode. One option that I recommend, which is super budget friendly, are Apple headphones. Not AirPods. AirPods don't have the greatest mic on them, but the old Apple headphones with a wire and a microphone on them, those are great if you're just getting started on recording podcasts. If you want something a bit more professional sounding, a good budget-friendly option that we recommend is the Audio-Technica ATR2100X USB mic. This is a great choice for suppressing background noise and room echo, and it also comes with a USB-C, so you can plug it directly into your computer, and it also comes with an XLR cable if you wanted to invest in a mixer. If you're willing to invest a bit more money, I highly recommend the microphone that I'm actually using right now, the Audio-Technica AT2020 USB+. I found this super simple to use when I started my podcast because I was able to just take it out of the box. I didn't have to set any software, just plug it into my computer and press record. It produces a sound quality that's crisp and professional, unlike a lot of other budget-friendly mics that sound hollow and grainy. Now, unless your guest is always doing podcasts, they're probably gonna come with headphones that have a microphone on them, and that will be the microphone that they use. Like I said earlier, these are fine. We just recommend to do a test recording before recording the bulk of your interview, just to make sure that all of your audio levels are crisp and clear and good to go. Now, if you're recording remotely, you're going to want to have some headphones. You can use any headphones for this. The main purpose of this is to prevent audio bleed, which is when your mic picks up the output of your guest's mic. The third thing that you're going to want is a camera if you are recording remotely. It's great to record video so that you can use that content and repurpose it for social media afterwards. For this, you can use your computer's webcam. Modern computers tend to have a high quality webcam, but if you want to ensure really high quality video, you could use a DSLR or an external webcam. And you can also use your phone. And if you want to learn more about how to do this, you can read our blog post called How to Use Your Phone as an External Webcam, and it's linked below. Once you have your setup ready to go, you're going to want to prepare your guests. You want to schedule them ahead of time, and using an online scheduler like Calendly makes this easy. You're going to want to send them a reminder email ahead of time, maybe a couple days before the interview recording, just to remind them that the interview is coming up. In this email, you can include any noise tips and tricks to make sure that they're set up properly for the interview. Some that we recommend are not to wear jingly jewelry or that will be picked up in the microphone, to turn off any notifications. You want to let them know to record in a small room, the quieter the better, and if it has carpet, that's really going to help with any echo. Some guests may want an outline of what to expect in the interview, so include this now if need be. And lastly, they're probably going to need a link to wherever you're going to be interviewing them on, so you can include that in this email or you can send it to them closer to the interview date. Now your guest is up to date and your setup is all ready to go, so we're going to talk about how you can actually record remotely. Now I'm going to talk about two different ways to do this. The first one is with the Riverside app on your iPhone or your Android. So if you're going to be using this, you can ignore anything I just said about equipment because you don't need anything but your phone. The Riverside app is super easy to use, very user-friendly. You can use it to host your episodes. You can send a guest link to your guest so they can join either from the web or on their phone. When you're recording, Riverside will upload the recording to the cloud, so when you're done recording, you can head to Riverside on the web to download separate audio and video tracks that you can then move into the post-production phase. So the first thing that you're going to do is download the Riverside FM app on your phone. You'll see all of the studios that you've created in the past, and you can create a new one. From here, you can invite people. You can invite them as a guest. These people will be part of your show, or an audience member can watch the recording process live. You can send a link to your studio directly through email, or you can copy the link and send it through a different form of messaging like text message. Head on into your studio. This is the Riverside Green Room. This is the same view that your guests will see when they're waiting to enter the studio. From here, you can check your camera view and you can toggle your mic and camera on and off. This is the Riverside Studio. As you can see, Riverside uploads the recording throughout the entire recording process. The upload will save automatically so that when you head over to Riverside on the web, you can download separate tracks for both you and your guest. If you're not going to record on your phone, the other option is to use a computer. You can use a platform like Zoom or Skype, but these don't record locally on your computer, meaning that your recording is completely dependent on internet connection. They also heavily compress your files, so you don't get that high quality sound that you're trying for, and you can't download separate tracks for each speaker. And, frankly, they weren't made for podcasting. Riverside is a platform that was made by podcasters for podcasters. So we've made sure that it's super easy to use specifically for the reason that you're using it. Riverside makes it easy to record with up to 8 guests at the same time, and it records locally on both you and your guests' computers, and then uploads that recording to the cloud. This means that any internet issues that happen throughout the recording aren't going to affect the quality of the final exported video and audio. When you're done recording, you can download separate tracks from both you and your guest, which is good because it preserves the sound quality of both sides of the conversation. Riverside allows people to watch the live recording of your show with an audience link and call in live to ask questions. So when you're ready to record, head over to Riverside FM. You can sign up for a free trial, or if you have an account, log in. The first thing that you're going to do is create a new reusable studio. Now you want to invite your guests. You can send your guests the guest link, or you can invite them directly through email. This is the Riverside Green Room, where you can pick your input and your output, and this is the same screen that your guests will see when they're waiting to enter the studio. Before you head in, you must click whether or not you are wearing headphones. This means that if you're not wearing headphones or your guest isn't wearing headphones, Riverside will enable our echo cancellation feature. This is the Riverside Studio, and you can actually invite your guests directly from here as well, and your guests can join both on the web and on their phone. Once your guest joins the studio, you'll see them pop up here, and you're able to check their input and output and adjust their audio levels if need be. As you can see, Riverside continuously uploads the recording throughout the recording process. When you're done recording, you're going to want to click View Recordings, and this will bring you to your studio recordings page, and here you'll be able to download separate audio and video tracks for both you and your guest. You can also edit your content with Riverside's editor tool. As you can see, it's super straightforward and really easy for your guests to navigate their way into the studio. Remote podcasting is a great way to have more guests on your show and opens up the opportunity to have those high-profile guests on that you've been dying to interview. You just want to make sure that you have a good setup and that your guests know how to come prepared in order to make the recording run smoothly, and make sure to run a test recording before you get into the bulk of your interview to make sure that all audio levels are clear and crisp and good to go. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to let us know who your dream guest is to have on your podcast in the comments, and make sure to subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media for more media tips and tricks.